Hey, BookTube, Chelsea, the Reading Outlaw, here to do another chunk of five books for 2017. This is books 36 through 40 in my recently read wrap-up. A bunch of these books you will have already heard me talk about in a previous video. That includes book number 36, which is Ashwin by Kit Rocha. This is the first book in the new Kit Rocha series, the Gideon's Rider series. It overlaps with her Beyond series in that they take place within the same kind of system of neighborhoods in this geographical area. So there are character overlaps and kind of brief character sightings and mentions from characters you met in her Beyond series, but you don't need to have read those books necessarily to really understand what's going on in these books. So they make a really great entry point if you don't want to read the last 9, 11, however many books there were. You do, though. You do. You do want to read them. You definitely do. But I talk way more about this book in the Sexy Saturdays video that I did not too long ago, so I will link that down below, as well as in a card up here. Also in that video, you hear me talk about book 37, which is Something About You by Julie James. This is a political kind of thriller that basically takes an ADA and an undercover FBI agent and pits them on a case after some tension that they've had together in the past, and they are kind of working together to figure out what happens when the assistant ADA kind of overhears a murder, or maybe a murder, and she becomes a witness. And yeah, as always, there's sexual tension and good banter. I really like Julie James's romances in that they take place in DC, in and around DC, and they really have that high political component. I'm really reading another one of hers now that takes place with two undercover FBI agents. And so if romance with like hardcore political established characters and intrigue is your thing, I definitely recommend her writing. Her sex scenes are really great. I'm not like over the heels in love with it the way that I've been with some of the other romances that I've been reading recently and some of the other writers I've been reading recently, but I still am really enjoying it and really recommend you pick it up if that is kind of a sub genre of romance that you're looking for. Book number 38 is A Gathering of Shadows by V.E. Schwab. This is the second book in her Darker Shade of Magic trilogy series thing. I didn't love it. It was fine. I think I gave it 2 stars. It's whatever. It was a BookTube SFF book pick. I just do not get along with Victoria / V.E. Schwab. I've said that before about Victoria Schwab when I've reviewed others of her books. I just don't particularly care for the worlds that she creates or the characters that she makes. I understand why people love it. I definitely liked this one more than the first one, but on the whole, it was just not for me. After that, I listened to Hillbilly Elegy, A Memoir of Family and Culture in Crisis by J.D. Vance. And this book is interesting. I had a really hard time kind of figuring out how I felt about it until I was talking to my friend Jenny about it from Reading the End podcast. And she used the phrase intellectual carpetbagging. And that really stuck with me and really resonated with me and kind of helped to sum up some of the problems that I have with Hillbilly Elegy. It's really an interesting memoir about poor whites in the rural Ohio and West Virginia area. I talked about it a little bit on the podcast, and I was still coming to terms with how I felt about it, but the more I think about it, the more I don't necessarily care for it and don't know how highly I would recommend it. It's a very interesting memoir, but I don't necessarily know how I feel or how much I agree with what it says about class and culture in America. I don't know. I just don't know how I feel about it. If you've read Hillbilly Elegy, comment down below and maybe you can help me sort out my feelings. But the last book that I'm going to talk about and the last book I read is The Hidden Oracle, which is the first book in the Trial of Apollo series by Rick Riordan. This was another BookTube SFF Awards book read and another one that I did not love. My primary problem with this book is the Apollo Daphne myth that gets mentioned in this book and how that gets played off for middle graders and really glossed over the fact that Daphne had to turn herself into a tree to avoid being raped by Apollo. And that is a really tricky subject to handle for middle graders, but it's also something that needs to be handled really, really well when you're gonna take on Apollo as a main character. And I just don't love the way Rick Riordan did it. Yeah, so let me know down below if you've read it and what your thoughts are, especially when it comes to tackling mythos and subject matter like that in a book for middle graders. But yeah, that wraps up books 36 through 40. Let me know down below which of these you've read, which of these you might pick up. As always, you can come find me all over the internet to talk books with you guys. Until next time, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and have happy reading. Bye.